you want Unity 3D, CryEngine, or Unreal Engine tutorials, like, comment, or subscribe for more. Today, we are going to add textures to our objects in CryEngine. There are several routes we can go with to accomplish this task. However, I am going to go with using SubSAR files, which are textures with shaders made using Substance Designer. Substance Designer is the industry's reference material creation and scan processing tool. More than 95% of AAA game projects currently in development use Substance, as well as most prestigious visual effects and animation studios. Create amazing looking materials with full control and an infinity of variations. Edit complete texture sets instantly with Substance Designer's node-based workflow and produce procedural, scan-based, or hybrid substance and MDL materials that will be directly compatible with your renderer or game engine. It costs $149.99. It should be noted that you can use Substance Designer with Unreal Engine and Unity 3D as well. But I digress. We are talking about CryEngine today. So let's sit back, relax, and learn how to add textures to our basic models in CryEngine. To begin, let's click on File and New. Create a new level with the terrain at whatever size you want. I will go with the default settings. Call it whatever you'd like, but I will call it Mother of God. Navigate to the basic shapes folder we created in the previous video. Link is in the card at the top. Drag one of the models onto the scene. I will go with the monkey because mojojojo. Use the move tool by selecting it or by pressing the number one key to move the model above the terrain. Now, if you don't have Substance Designer, that's fine. You can go to textures.com to grab some with premium credits, or you can just download the individual files using free credits. The link will be in the description below. And because I'm a good guy, I will showcase using both methods. One using the SubSAR file and generating the files you need, and with adding the textures themselves. The texture itself, we will use the marble red textures, but again, you can choose whatever ones you want from the site and follow along. Let's start with the easy one, texture version. Create a folder called texture version and import the TIFF files you downloaded into the folder. You can do this with a simple drag and drop. Click on Tools in Material Editor, expand the Basic Shapes folder in the Material Editor window and select Monkey. The names should basically line up accordingly. Diffuse goes into Diffuse, Hype map goes into hype map, and so on and so forth. With this one, we only need diffuse and hype map though. Click on save and look at the model in the viewport. You can rotate by clicking on the rotate tool or by pressing the number 2 key. Now we can move on to the SubSAR version. Let's begin by adding the UV sphere to the scene and shifting it up to above the terrain floor. Inside the SubSAR version folder that I create, we should create a new folder called SubSAR textures. I'm going to go with my cliff-t iran SubSAR file and drag it into the SubSAR version folder. Right click on the SubSAR file, highlight the create instance and select the name of the SubSAR file next to create instance. A dialog box will show up. Select the SubSAR textures folder and click OK. Give it a few moments and inside the SubSAR textures folder, a new SubSAR file with your texture files will have appeared inside. Now we do the same thing as before and open the material editor by selecting on tools in materials editor. Expand the basic shapes folder and select the UV sphere. Your diffuse is the diff file, your specular is the spec file, the height map is the height file, and your bump map is your DDNA file. If for any reason that the model in the scene does not update appropriately, just delete it and drag the file back in and it will have the texture on it properly. This is a bug that can sometimes happen. You too can be a CryEngine texturing boss. And now this concludes the basic tutorial on adding textures to models in CryEngine. This has been Jesco, the Rising Phoenix Dev, and I'm signing out.